Now that you've mastered your basic editing skills, now it's time to dial it up and take it to the next level. And I'm here with Rosie to teach you some of these techniques to take it just a bit further.
Today we're going to be moving a little bit more towards the kind of whimsical fashion sphere. So I've got my lovely model in a ball gown and we're going to take her to a chaise.
And what kind of skills are we going to be covering today?
Okay, so we're going to be covering compositing, which is basically stitching two images together. I want to make the dress really long, so we're going to take two shots and make it happen.
So, Rosie, this is a lovely set. I love what you've done with this. What are we trying to achieve here?
So, basically, we've got our lovely model, Sasha. She's here with us today. And we want to create something that's like romantic fairy tale, roses, pretty flowers. One of my goals for this picture is to be able to stitch different pictures of the dress to make it look a lot longer than it really is. Okay. So by having the camera on a tripod, it means that we can keep the image still so everything stitches together seamlessly.
Okay, and what's the camera that we're working with today?
We're on the R5 today. I've gone for the 35 prime, which is a 1.8 aperture. We've got our shutter speed to 1 over 400, which keeps the shots quite sharp and quick. And then we're also going to be changing the color temperature manually today, which is a little bit of an update for this one. You can see here, we can just make it warmer just by using the wheel. And if we look at that, much prettier, right? Much prettier.
Much better on the eyes.
This is going to be really straightforward. I just need you to move your arms around in different poses. Lovely. That's great.
And how many photos would you typically take when you do this?
I would say about 50 to 100.
The face detect is just following you as you're doing it.
Making my job easy.
Love that.
I'm just going to go up and down and just grab a quick background shot if I need to as well.
Okay, and why do you need to do that?
So if I want to expand the image into a portrait shot for Instagram, it means that I've got all the assets that I need to stitch together. So I'm not just limited to a landscape shot.
Gotcha. What's next?
Okay, we're going to pose the model, do a few test shots. This dress, as lovely as it is, it's not quite long enough to give the wow that I really wanted from this final shot. So by shooting these extra pictures of the dress, we can stitch it all together and just make it so that the dress comes as long as we want it to.
Nice.
Smashing.
I'll give you that back.
Thank you.
Okay, so what's next?
Okay, now we need to get the pictures off the SD card, load them into our editing software, and make the magic happen.
Let's check it out.
Let's do it.
Okay, now that we have all our shots, what's next?
Okay, so I'm going to put them into DPP, have a look through all of them, choose my favourites.
What's DPP?
DPP is Digital Photo Professional. It's basically Canon's free software, and it helps you process all your RAWs whilst maintaining the best quality from your files. So here we go, we've got my top 8 images. Time to export these, and I'm not going to do any of the tweaks we mentioned, just because everything in camera just went to plan, which never really happens, but yes.
Okay. And then once you've exported it, what's next?
Then I'm going to take it into my image editing software and we're going to do the more complex tweaks like compositing my dress together.
Okay.
Great.
Let's do it.
So let's start with just bringing out the dress. And I'm going to take the dress that was closest to your knees to begin with.
And this is what compositing is, basically.
This is essentially what compositing is, yeah. Okay. So I can now start to put the dress wherever I want it to. So taking my eraser tool, and I'm going to put the opacity to 100%. Okay. And that's going to make sure it takes out all of the image rather than just part of the image.
Ah.
Yeah, so you
so
see
it's
how
like
it's
overlaying them and taking the bits you don't want out of it.
Exactly. Okay. So it's just blending everything in.
And obviously this goes back again to earlier on when you were making sure that he sort of matches and...
Correct,
so now
yeah.
It's making sense.
And it makes sense as well because not only is the dress going to blend well here, but you're also going to have the shadows matching, which is really, really important. So just going to take out the bulk of the stuff that we don't need, which is these flowers. So even just dragging and dropping here, you can already see the difference that that's going to make. Even just rotating it there makes a huge difference. I really like that. I think that looks really good. And I could even make this dress a bit smaller. Line it up here, and you can see already that that just fits in with the rest of the dress. So I'd say I'm pretty happy with the dress there, but there's maybe one more step. So I'm gonna crop the image here like this. I'd like to make the canvas size a bit taller, because again, if I'm going to post it on Instagram, I want it to
fit aspect ratio.
Correct. Right. Okay. You can use something called content aware fill. So if I just select that area, so edit content aware fill, so it will kind of guess what the content would be, and that's not too bad. It's a bit clony for me, but it does the job.
Okay.
If you didn't want perfection, you'd be pretty happy. And then if I wanted to, I could use the rest of the pictures of the flowers that you very carefully held
arranged
like a crab for me.
Yeah.
And I could put those in around the edges and just bulk things out a little bit more.
Yeah.
And you can see the end result is, you know, just really beautiful and pretty.
Get to this point, what have you done so far?
Okay, so what we've done is we've taken about 3 different pictures of the dress, stitched it together onto the end of the original picture, warped the perspective a little bit with the flowers, we've expanded the image, we've made it taller, and we've taken a shot that was originally a landscape, and we've made it a portrait.
Amazing, thank you very much.
Thank you.